Mauricio, I wasn't in that section because I wanted them. Didn't like the idea. But I think that if you want to move forward with the red towel, I think there's some things that they would like to have some fundamental opportunities to have some input.
Back in Johannesburg, the WBC introduced the use of the red card for the communications between the referee and the ring doctor when there's a difference of languages. And the greatest referee in history went crazy, Arthur Mercante. He got so upset that the WBC would implement a protocol for communications. And he believed the WBC was taking away from the referee the decision to stop the fight. And the presentation went on, and precisely my father told Arthur Mercante and showed the video what had happened. That year, Arthur had he's refereeing a fight in Mexico City, 50,000 people. The doctor only speaks Spanish. Arthur only speaks English. Very noisy in the crowd. And Ricardo Lopez got a huge cut. So the doctor jumps in the ring and tells Arthur, yes, stop the fight. Going like this. Oh no, but nodding. Yes. But saying it's an ugly cut, stop the fight. And Arthur understood that it was okay, he could continue. He left the round go. At the end of the round, we had to jump and tell Arthur that the doctor was saying it was a huge cut. So Arthur responds to my father, well, Jose, I didn't understand what he was saying, so how do you expect me to? That's why the red card was implemented. So the red towel is a mechanism that we're going to introduce. We're going to do a full protocol with a specific guidelines as well. But referees are referees, and they will always have concerns about anything that is introduced, and that's human nature. So we're going to start with it. We'll see how it goes. We did receive a proposal, and I would like to see if it has merit, to have a blue towel for the one corner and the red towel for the other. So the referee has a visual for what it's coming from, but most of the times when you see a towel thrown, it's very obvious who is asking the fight to be stopped. So we will create the protocol, share it with the Ring Officials Committee. We're gonna start using it in the pilot process tomorrow in the fights. But this is a situation that has to have a lot of feedback.
I really believe that it just caught them off guard, and it was something they wanted to adjust to. But it was a good discussion, and Steve St. Germain and Joe Scobie did a wonderful job, and I thank them. They put the whole thing together, actually Joe did. But I want to tell you, I had to be in two places at once yesterday. So I had a brand new PowerPoint training program in my computer. And I had to be in this room for the ratings. So I handed my bag to Chris Migliori, who had never seen this program, and said, Chris, go teach it. And Chris went up and did a phenomenal job. So I'd like to thank him. I'd like him to grab a microphone and give us a brief. Nobody wants you to have the microphone, Chris.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. My name is Chris Migliori. I'm an official from Las Vegas, Nevada. Thank you, President Suleiman. Board of Governors. We had a beginner course yesterday with a lot of the local officials It was excellent. We started from teaching the basics of a scorecard, especially the new WBC scorecard with the close, moderate, decisive, and extreme decisive, which is the new way to, as a judge, to go through a round so that you can accurately understand where you are throughout the round, but also if you are asked afterwards, you can use it as a test to say, that was a very close round, that was a moderate round. We had about 40 to 50 people in the room. By the end, they were scoring fights. A lot of them got it correctly. And with the close, moderate, decisive, which was great to see. They were enthusiastic, asked terrific questions, even with the language barrier. We went through about 100 slides. It was very exciting to see how excited they were to learn about the sport and learn to be a new judge. And hopefully soon they can use what they learned in live action. But it was tremendous to see, and obviously the sport is growing in the area and with all the officials there, so it was really exciting to see.
Thank you. Thank you, Chris. Just in closing, I would just like to touch on a couple of things of what we talked about in the overall judges seminar. This past year, we have discovered that three good officials seem to start disagreeing. We've had some strange scores in this last year, and so we have tried to understand how that happened. We have really emphasized that the scoring criteria is scoring punches, effective aggression, ring gentlemanship, or control. Those are the only three scoring criteria. Nothing else is in there. And
Dwayne,
we've really worked with
can you please
to Dwayne, understand
Dwayne,
that.
Sorry, Dwayne?
Yes?
Can you please elaborate on the scoring criteria? Please explain exactly what is the what the judge must see, must score and take as a criteria to have the final score of the round.
That's really a great question. We have tried to define that much easier. The first scoring criteria is a scoring punch. A scoring punch is something that lands in the scoring zone. The scoring zone is from the top of the head, splitting the ears, down the shoulders, to the hip or the navel, wherever the referee is going to call it, forward. But the punches that land in that area, except on the arms from down to the wrist of the gloves, this is basically a defensive mechanism, and therefore we do not take that as a score. The upper arms is a scoring area, and you must use good judgment. For example, I know there's nobody in the room that ever watched Rocky Marciano but me, but his first punches of the fight were to the arms, because as hard as he could, because when a fighter was hit hard in that, they would drop their arms. So you have to use common sense. A scoring punch is not like amateur, that they tap him in that scoring zone, oh, that's 1 point, or that's 2 points. A scoring punch, we look for the effect of the punch. The effect of the punch is not damage. The effect of the punch is the result of the punch. And we showed about seven different things. Number one, a fighter would immediately clinch after getting hit with a hard punch. Or a fighter would back away and go another direction. Or a fighter would stagger. Or a fighter's knees would buckle. Or a fighter would blink hard. These, we look for the effect of the punch, not the number of punches. And that's the first criteria and the largest criteria. If everything is even on the scoring punches, then you would look to who's the most effective aggressor. What is effective aggression? Some people say it's the fighter moving forward. No. It's a fighter who is more effective by being aggressive. A fighter could be coming forward, but the effective aggressor could be the fighter going backwards, that immediately when the fighter would throw a punch, he would immediately throw a counterpunch over the top and score. It's effective aggression. And effective aggression could be to the right, to the left, forward or backwards. He's just getting off and he's controlling the punches. The last thing is we still use the term ring generalship. What that has defined down to is who's controlling it. So if you can't find something to score within the scoring punches, you move to effective aggression. If you can't find something to effective aggression, you go to ring generalship. Who's controlling the action? Who's trying to put the fighter in a position to hit him?
Eric Priest.
Who's doing